Quinawash 12, brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. The future in trucks is here. The all-new 2014 Chevy Silverado delivers where you need it. Strength, towing, payload, torque, and fuel efficiency. It works as hard as you do. Chevy, the official vehicle of the Green Bay Packers.
Thanks for logging on to WISN.com. I'm meteorologist Chris Gloninger with this web weather update. Two more days in the 50s, Thursday, and closing out the work week on Friday. We're down into the 40s for Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. These temperatures 10 to 15 degrees below average. And some of the forecast models are still hinting for the third day in a row, chance for some snow Monday, Tuesday, and into next Wednesday. Satellite shows the cloudy day we had, even a couple of showers to see from West Bend through Beaver Dam. The air mass is drying out, so a lot of this is having a tough time reaching the ground. But if you look at the big picture, that spin that was over Minneapolis yesterday is now over Ontario, Canada, and it's continuing to eject into the northeast. Eventually, we have this dry wedge of air that does move in. Up until that point, the weather stays fairly active. The trough is just about through this dotted black line, and once it's to our south and east, our chances for showers will greatly diminish, and that happens during the overnight, during the day tomorrow as well. As we take you hour by hour, this area of low pressure develops along that cold front, and it will actually keep it stalled out across Lake Erie for much of the day. Notice the showers across Lake Michigan. They'll come real close tomorrow. In fact, it might look like it's going to rain almost at any time, but this ridge will win out. High pressure will eventually give this system the nudge east. During the late morning and early afternoon, those showers really are only affecting lower Michigan through northern Indiana. We still have mostly cloudy skies. It's a wedge right here from the UP through central Wisconsin and into Iowa that we're expecting high pressure. During the afternoon, that high eventually will give that system a kick to the east, and eventually it'll be in upstate New York. We might see a couple of late day breaks of sunshine early Thursday afternoon. Our storm threat tomorrow is a zero with high pressure building in. We'll see mostly cloudy skies, maybe a sprinkle right along the lake shore. Tonight, there may be an isolated frost. Some areas into the middle 30s, that's the north country to the Dells, 36 degrees. Everyone else will likely be safe from a frost or freeze with temperatures due to the cloud cover staying in the mid 40s. Even though we're in the mid 40s for overnight lows, our daytime highs will only be in the 50s, mid 50s. It's a 10 degree climb with those mostly cloudy skies. 57 Sheboygan, Racine 55 in Lake Geneva, Burlington, a couple of 56s from Watertown through Beaver Dam and Fond du Lac. Another day where numbers are uniform across Wisconsin. As you look at Saturday, 40s and 30s fairly widespread, the northern plains and western Great Lakes. Might even get colder on Sunday as those 40s shift into central Iowa, Illinois, and Indiana. 30s as close as Minneapolis across the UP. Also for the Packers game, Sunday afternoon kickoff, I think, is at 3:30. So it's going to be chilly, and there might be some lake effect snow showers. Thursday, high of 56. Lots of clouds around. Still into the 40s at noontime. It's cool and blustery. Even though we're in the 50s, it'll feel like it's in the 40s. We'll have a northwest wind at 10 to 15 miles per hour for much of the day. Mostly cloudy again on Friday, 55. A rain or snow shower on Saturday, a high of 48. On Sunday, 49 degrees, mostly cloudy, some flurries to the north. Rain to a mix on Monday as we peak out at 46. We'll see an overnight low of 35. It's a break in between systems on Tuesday, followed by a wintry mix on Wednesday. This could come with accumulations for parts of the area after overnight lows start off in the mid-30s. Not much going on this weekend, but thanks for logging on to WISN.com. Your next web update will be posted a little bit later on this evening. Have a great evening.